I think the word to describe what we've experienced since Sam started playing football is surreal.
Hey everybody, I'm Sam Gordon. I love football, and I love this football too. But mostly, I love fair play.
The fair play comes later in Sam's story. Her first play blew up the internet. When Sam was just 9, she ran wild in an all-boys football league, becoming an overnight social sensation. The petite, powerful persona suddenly a wanted commodity at every level.
Which camera do I look at?
Just smiling.
Flashing with national and international stars. As a teenager fighting for equal opportunity for girls, Sam's message carries across ages and genders.
She has a persona that's sort of public and that is owned by lots of women.
Now suing Utah schools for equal participation. But as reality closes the door on her football dreams, Sam's now going global with her Olympic football dream.
Most people don't know the whole Sam Gordon story.
Before her run to football glory and all the incredibly surprising star power perks.
Do you have Twitter?
Yeah.
You do?
Sam's first enormous hurdle was internal, growing through deep personal tragedy.
It's definitely been a part of the story that I don't think we've ever really, you know, talked about and gotten into before, and it is a thing I'm comfortable talking about because it did happen, and, you know, if we try to ignore it, that just becomes part of the problem.
Her mother spiraled down and out of Sam's life due to opioid addiction.
I think, you know, as a four-year-old, I didn't really grasp exactly what was happening at the time, but I, you know, you did see, oh, like, my mom wasn't around anymore, and like, oh, what happened?
And I ended up having sole custody of the children, and it was, the kids were heartbroken, you know, they've got, her brother was 7, Sam's 4, her younger brother was 1, so I've got 3 children under 7, and I'm thinking, how am I supposed to help these kids cope with everything that they're going through? They're just, you know, they're crying, they miss their mom, and it's a really difficult situation.
It's been sad to see it happen and how much it can just, you know, take a person. And she was amazing. She was a really, you know, great mom. And then to see, you know, how drugs have really just, you know, taken away a lot of her life, and it really is an epidemic. And this is the saddest part of it all, is that she would get better for a little bit, but then in the end, just like, kind of go back to it. And I think the moments where she is good, you know, it's great to have that relationship, and then you kind of just have to, you know in your head that it's probably not gonna ever get like really better again.
So now the straight A student has a rare opportunity to talk straight to peers and the public.
And it does open up a conversation to talk about drug addiction and how bad it really can be. And so I think it gives me a more personal connection to it, to talk about it in a better way that's not just like, oh, drugs are bad. I can be like, well, like, look at this. Like, they're not good for you.
You know, this drug addiction issue led to a divorce, and to see how naive I was about the harmful effect and consequences of drug addiction, I had no idea.
It was an education in real time for Brent, too. Crisis management with a heavy dose of love and sports therapy.
How am I gonna help them cope? And I've just gotta put on my happy face, come home, be the single dad, make them dinner, and then we're gonna head outside and we're gonna play sports.
Neighborhoods that we like grew up in, very full of, you know, kids and parks and everything, so we're always able to like go out there and be athletic and everything. And then, you know, we've got the beautiful mountains and like lakes and everything around us, and so it's super nice to like just go out and be active and go on hikes and really enjoy nature. So it's super amazing area to live in. I think sports were definitely a way for our whole family to cope with everything.
Sam would always come up and ask the coach if she could run the sprints with us. And, you know, I'm 3 years older than her, and I'm like, oh, shoot. And then she'd get in the line and then smoke all of us in the sprints. That coach was like, hey, you should play football.
Mm-hmm.
And then she did.
Then I was like, okay. And then me and Max actually did like a bunch of training beforehand. Like we would go do our own like little speed and agility crap and all the good hitting drills and everything. I was like ready for that first season.
And so, armed with a steely swagger forged through the pain of early childhood tragedy, a soft side soothed by a loving, encouraging family, and flashing this innate, insane ability to run around, over and through every challenge at the age of 9, the legend of Sweet Feet was born.
At first it was, Sam's just playing because she wants to have fun. But then, once she had her first football game and she scored 5 touchdowns on 8 carries, then I thought, well, this looks pretty fun. Maybe we could put together a little video and share this little girl, you know, doing so well against the boys, and we'll see, you know, if people enjoy that.
I was walking home from school, it was like the day after, and he like comes running out because he got home before me. He's like, Sam, Sam, all these TV shows are calling, oh my gosh. And I was like, what? That was
crazy.
A moment of like, wow, that's a thing.
Because it went viral fast.
Who knew? 5 million views in 3 days? And next thing you know, she's on the Wheaties box and being interviewed in New York. For about a month after that video went viral, Sam didn't even sleep in her own bed because she was out doing the TV show circuits, being invited to U.S. Women National Team, practicing games.
They're a lot bigger than me, so it's a little like, whoa.
Being invited to go practice with the 49ers, going to attend a game with the NFL commissioner in New York. So it was really a whirlwind.
Are you having fun with this?
Yeah, I'm having fun with it. As long as this doesn't go on forever, then I'm fine with it. Yeah, cameras following me around everywhere. That wouldn't be very fun.
Of course, when you're the only one crushing established norms, like a little girl running rings around the boys, there will be blowback.
I think the time that I found the most like people going against me was just at tryouts for my first year. I went out there, there were 172 boys, and in every single speed and agility drill, I was number one. The boys just couldn't believe that they were getting beat by a girl. So they would start these chants in the lines. It would be like, beat the girl, beat the girl. We would go out and do our hitting practices and stuff, and I would knock a boy on the butt, and you know, a parent would come out and like grab him by the face mask and be like, don't get beat by a girl. I mean, the crazy thing is that I got all this attention for this, and I wasn't trying to do that. I was just trying to go out and play football and have fun. I didn't even realize at the time, like, oh, you know, I'm like the only girl. So this is
a quick tour through Sam's room of fame reflects all the hype and hope.
And this is kind of where we just decided to keep everything. That's all my famous stuff. I don't even know how to say it. The Wheaties box, this thing was awesome. I remember the first time I saw it was on Good Morning America, and they like revealed it. I think my grandpa took that photo. And awesome, who can say they've been on a Wheaties box? That's pretty cool. This is when I went to the U.S. Women's National Team and kind of talking with them, and then Alex Morgan signed the cleats and gave me a little message. She's one of my heroes. I had watched her play in the Olympics and in the World Cups, and it was something like amazing. And then here she was in person, and I remember she gave me a piggyback ride, and I was like, wow. You know, now looking back on it and kind of seeing, you know, hearing Abby Wambach speak and other people speak on behalf of, they're trying to get like equal pay and everything right now, that it's really all a fight together, and everybody's taking steps in different ways, and that kind of our whole stories, you know, they go together more than you would think. And so, I mean, at the time I didn't realize it, but we were all fighting for our own little things.
I mean, who gets a life-size cutout? That's
the best thing.
Wait, is it bigger than you?
Not anymore. This used to be life-size. Like, I was this little. Yeah.
When Sam outgrew organized youth football leagues in Utah, she hit a gender glass ceiling in football. Then, while carrying her message of hope and opportunity for younger girls, Sam found the magic in paying it forward.
Sam was asked to speak at a middle school assembly. And so when she went to select somebody to come up and participate, she asked a question.
Are there any girls here who play football?
And every single girl raised their hand.
If you want something done, just go do it.
The Gordon's Utah Girls Tackle Football League started with 50 players. Now, 5 years in, 10 times that many play.
I think it's amazing that, you know, I can be inspiring to other girls and helping other girls out there. And I think I've had a lot of awesome opportunities that have come with, you know, pioneering this girls' league.
And then Sam could see that, hey, I have a little bit of an obligation. I don't want to put too much pressure on her, but you know what? You've had this attention. Now you need to use it to make the world a better place.
A better place in Sam's world.
Ain't no party like a Mustang party. Hoorah.
Includes sanctioned high school all-girl football teams. Not even close to a thing in Utah right now.
If you're gonna be a publicly funded school and you're just gonna say, hey, we're gonna support and invest in one activity, and by the way, it's the most popular activity, and it's just for the boys, That discrimination is illegal.
So Sam and her lawyer dad dialed up the public pressure, filing a class action federal lawsuit against three school districts and the Utah High School Athletic Association. Amy Donaldson is an award-winning journalist in the state of Utah. Girls sports has been her beat for years.
What the lawsuit's aiming to do is say, any way you look at it, they're not giving women the same number of athletic opportunities that they give to boys. They're just not.
I mean, it's frustrating to know that I probably won't get the opportunity to play, you know, high school football the way that, you know, it is for boys, but it's a fight and it's a long process, and if I can get it for somebody else, then I'm gonna try and do that.
At such a young age, she understands that she's not just speaking for herself. It's not just about what Sam wants to do, what Sam is, and certainly that's a driving force, but it's also like, I owe it to these other people and these other women and these other girls to do something that would be easier not to do.
For all her hard yards earned on and off the field, in February 2019, the night before the Super Bowl, the National Football League made Sam Gordon the first recipient of the NFL's prestigious Game Changer Award.
Tomorrow, millions of girls will be watching the Super Bowl. But watching the sport we love the most is not enough. We want to play football too, on separate girls' teams. I know girls want to play because I asked them. Before Title IX, some people thought that girls were not interested in playing sports, but they were wrong. They were just as wrong as people who argued that women did not want to vote, to hold public office, or to be lawyers or doctors. People who think girls don't want to play football are wrong too. By growing up playing football, women will have the same experience and knowledge of the game that men have. Men that end up as coaches, scouts, executives, and broadcasters. If we are allowed to play, the doors to those opportunities will be thrown wide open. Equality is our Super Bowl.
Then the very next night during the Patriots-Rams Super Bowl, Sam lit up a star-studded NFL commercial with a legendary cameo.
The fans, the moment, and everything else that makes you say, oh boy.
Boy, this is a great party.
Get out there, old man.
Full beast.
Can I have a ball, please?
You want this? Yeah. Come and get it.
A lot of people were trashing you, saying that you didn't belong in that commercial at all.
You ruined the commercial. Like if she ruined the commercial.
How many likes did you get?
Three. I think there's a lot of them that are just like, get back in the kitchen, go make a sandwich.
Sam's also in a social league of her own, already verified on Instagram.
Guys, it's Sam Gordon doing an Instagram takeover for On Her Turf. Right now I'm at Smith's Ballpark and I'm about to throw the first pitch at the Bees game, an honorary pitch, but I'm super excited. I just got to get it from that mound to the plate. I think I can do that.
Let's hear it for Sam.
So what's next in the big picture for this pocket pioneer? Pushing a career in this kind of football.
I mean, football, I know, isn't something that I could really do in the future, like actually playing it. And I think soccer is definitely going to be the priority. And I want to play that, you know, next level into colleges and hopefully into a professional and for the U.S. Women's National Team.
The here and now is chasing championships with a high-level club team and playing for the USA's West Regional Olympic Development Team. Of course, growing up in an Olympic host city, the memories of Salt Lake City 2002 ring around the valley. In the future Summer Olympics of Paris 2024, or LA 2028 providing a very present push.
It's definitely something you dream about as you, you know, play with these players in the ODP Olympic Development Program, and that's all your end goal in talking about being able to represent your country in something amazing as that. It's definitely a goal that we always aspire to reach.
For now, Sam is very much as she's always been, wise beyond her years, eyes on many prizes, yet always driven by a beaming inner spirit smile.
She's having a great time. She's playing sports, and she's doing all the stuff that you want a kid to do. And that's, I hear people say to me, why don't you just let her enjoy her high school career? And I'm like, she's enjoying it. Have you seen her? How enjoyable would it be to make a football commercial with the NFL?
Come and get it.
You have to put in the work, but you have the opportunity to get to that next level, to get to the Olympics and to these other things. And outside of sports, you can, you know, be the CEO and you can go to that next level. And I think
president?
That's president of the United States, you know? There's so much that you can go and do, and I want to, you know, tell girls that there's no limits to the opportunities they have.
That precedent-setting pint-sized ponytail was nicknamed Sweet Feet when she was 9. Now not quite all grown up, Sam is a force for fair play in international sports. And that is truly a sweet feat.
And I think it's amazing the platform that I've been given to speak about what I'm passionate about. And so, you know, I've been, you know, with great power comes great responsibility. Yeah, I got this attention, I'm gonna use it for the better.